So towers range in heights from as short as, we'll say, 100 feet all the way up to 2,000 feet or even slightly taller. In the case of a TV tower, they have an antenna at the very top because you want to get it to the very highest spot on the tower. So they go and build a tower up to 1,900 feet and then put a 100-foot antenna right on the top of that 1,900-foot tower. So you drive by a real tall tower, the only thing that's really being used is that very top of that tower, but it has to be way up there at 2,000 feet. And so that's how TV towers work, and that's why they're so tall, because a 2,000-foot TV tower can go out 75-mile radius, 150-mile diameter, and hit all those homes in that same amount of area. Those antennas on the top of those towers are very interesting. They come in different shapes and sizes. Some of them, in the old days, we had what we called a batwing antenna, and they have four directional elements, and they go all the way up, and they're kind of like a climbing ladder there, but they're shaped like a bat's wing, and that's why we call them a bat wing, because they have like these little flapper wings. They don't flap, they're solid, but they sort of look like a bat wing. Those are very easy to climb. You can basically just jump on them and, you know, climb up. Now, they're easy to climb, but they're not comfortable to climb, because the higher you get, the more narrow that the pipe, the round member that's in the middle, gets. So when you're at the bottom of a big 100 plus foot antenna, it might have a diameter of 3 feet, the pipe. But when you're at the top, it might have a diameter of 4 inches. So as you get up higher, the antenna walks, moves around, bobs back and forth. That's one type of antenna. That's the easy one. What we refer to as the slick sticks, that's the crazy antenna. And they generally have close to the same diameter from top to bottom. Now the inner core might be slightly get smaller, but they keep the outer piece of fiberglass. It's just a thin piece of fiberglass that goes all the way around it, and it's smooth and it's slick. It's literally shiny and slippery. And they have climbing pegs. The climbing pegs on those are often made of fiberglass. And so you're climbing up this big round piece of fiberglass with these other fiberglass pegs, which are quite ways apart. And all you see in front of you is a big round reddish orange structure. But if you look that way, or you look that way, you see nothing. And if you look behind you, there is nothing. All that's holding you on is your hands. So there's not very many people that really want to do that. How many people in a room of 100 people will raise their hand when you describe and show some pictures of a job climbing towers? How many will raise their hand? I say maybe 5%. Okay, so you get those five in, and you run them through training, and you prove them out, and maybe of that 5%, only 2.5 of them of those stay and keep working. Now, one day they climb to the top of a 2,000 footer and you say, you got to change the beacon. Go ahead. Now, of that two, how many are willing to do that? And in the middle of the night, because a lot of times that's why when we're on those, because they don't want to turn them off during the day. So it's a pretty exclusive club, the slick stick climbers in this world.
It was KDLT, one of the Rowena towers, and we went up, and I think we were just doing an inspection on it, maybe, or a relamp or something like that, but it was a little sketchy going up the first time. You know, you don't really have anything to really hook your monkey tail to, so what we did was get a extra long scare strap and go around both the pegs, so it made it a little bit easier.
I'd kind of gotten really comfortable with climbing towers, and nothing really had fazed me kind of at that point. And then I got up on my first stick. It was a lot of fun. View up there was spectacular. No, it's a cool thing. There's a lot of guys that they get up there and they're, nope, I'm not having this.
Yeah, being up there at night, that's a whole different thing. usually got a headlamp on, but I like to climb without the headlamp on when we're up there, just, you know, feeling the tower and stuff. But yeah, being up there when it's pitch black, and luckily we had a calm night when we were up there, so it was nice to even be up on the tower. And just seeing like the lights of Sioux Falls and Brandon, and then you got you know, all the stars are out and everything. It's just really cool. You got the wind farm off to the north. It blinks and lights up.
We were in Austin, Minnesota, doing a night climb, doing a relamp. Like 100 feet up, I didn't start feeling good. And I shut my headlamp off, and I felt just fine. It was weird.
I mean, I don't know if anybody else gets this. Tyler said he got it too, but when I climb in the at night with my headlamp on, it like gets like my orientation off or something. It almost makes you feel like you're starting to get sick a little bit.
I get to sit safe in my desk down in the front office, answer phone calls, and our guys are out there every single day as their job climbing really tall things, and especially when they climb the TV antennas. And I thought, if I was climbing it, I'd probably be afraid that it would snap off and plummet to the ground.
So I got a call from a customer early last summer, and he said that he was having troubles with his antenna, his feed line. And a little bit later, he sends me a message. He said, I think I found my problem. And there's a picture of his antenna laying on the ground. 100-foot TV antenna, 22,000-pound antenna, half buried in the dirt antenna. It's like, whoa, that ain't good. So that got some excitement going. Especially here, you know, a lot of us guys, we climb them. In fact, I've climbed that antenna. A lot of the guys that I worked with, we were all on that antenna. 2-3 of us at a time, even, working on that antenna. So that hit close to home for us. But otherwise, it landed right directly between, in the middle of two guy wires. It couldn't have landed more perfectly. And missed the, I mean, it didn't even hit the barbed wire fence. I mean, it hit nothing. It'll be fine to keep climbing sticks. There's a lot of them that have been up there. They're up there right now. They got ice on them. They're just bobbing away in the wind, hanging tight.
Yeah, I love being up there.